Okay, now we can apply some paint and some color to our head. So I might just go to view and not show the guideline. Now, normally you would paint underneath the lines if you're using the paintbrush, but I want to introduce the fill bucket, which is this tool here, the fill tool. Basically, the way it works is you choose your color. Let's say you want an orange, and then you just click, and it'll fill the area that you click on. So if you want green, you basically then choose the green, click where you want it to fill, and you can see what's happened. It'll fill the closed shape. I'll just undo that and zoom in. If I zoom in and when I click the face, you might notice on the edge that there's a bit of a white gap. If that's the case, you can undo your last move, click on the tool options, and see what says grow selection. You can actually make that a bit bigger, and this time when you click, it actually grows. It goes further beyond the area that you first clicked. I'll just undo that again, and now if I want to make it a smooth edge, I can bring this feathering radius up and watch what happens now. If I click here, it's got now a soft edge. So when you zoom back, it kind of looks like that. Not as pixelated, I guess. And so the fill tool may be something that you want to use. You might want to give this guy a red nose, and there it is. So that's a simple way of using the paint bucket tool to fill an area of color.